नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ॐ श्रीगणेशशारदागुरुभ्यो नमः So today's service is Aha Samvatsaro Vyalaha. Ahaha means Ahas. Ahas means day. Usually there is this expression called Dinaratram. Dinaratram means day and night. There is another expression called Aharnisham. That's also a very famous expression like Dinaratram. Aharnisham means day and night. So Ahar means day. You know a very famous word, Dasahara. Dasahara. Dasaha. It is Navaratris are 10 days or 9 nights. Navaratris are when you book a hotel. So that is Navaratri. Dasahara. Ahas. Ahas means day. So that why he is called Ahas? Why is this consciousness? It is called Ahas because it is always lightened up. When you are the consciousness is always lightened up. Right. Prakasa rupatvat. Because it is prakasa rupam. It is the one which lights the light. So it is called Ahaha. This Aha is like Namamsakalingam. That's why I'm saying it. So, no offense to Vishnuji, but because it is Namamsakam, it is Brahman. That's why I'm saying it. Anyway, Prakasa Rupatvat Ahaha. It is brilliance. Hence, Vishnu is called Aha. Next one, Samvatsaraha. Kalatmana Stitaha Vishnuhu Samvatsarai Tiktaha. He is called year. Samsara means year. So it is a unit of time. Year is a unit of time. He is called this time because he is in the form of time. Vishnu is in the form of Kala. Shankara does not quote anything, but one thing comes to my mind. Sambat Sarove Prajapatihi. There is one thing. Or even in the Yes. Right there. So, there and then also in Gita, Kalosmi aham loka kshekri pravrdhaha. Time I am, the destroyer of the worlds. This is the verse which came to that that guy who invented atom bomb. As soon as it was Oppenheimer, he said this. He quoted Bhagavad Gita, saying that I am time. So that's why he's called Samvatsara. Because Kala Rupatvat. Kalatmana Stitaha Vishnuhu Samvatsari Tyuktaha. So Ahaha Samvatsaraha. Aha Samvatsaro Vyalaha. You know, Vyali or Vyala means dragon in Kerala. That's what we say generally. So for, you know, in temples they have dragons. Vyali. Vyali. Without the va, they say in Tamil Nadu. In Kerala, they say the Sanskrit word. So, Yali means this, they use it for big chariots. The chariots, either there will be two horses or two Yalis.
Even in the temple, every Tramavati has
Yali. Yeah, the thing which metal, that is called a Prabhavali, behind deities. It has a very funny face. That face is Yali. So that is the meaning for Vyalaha generally. And in the Amrakosha, Vyalo Dushta Gaje Sarpe Khale Swapada Simha Yo. All this means Vyala. Simha. Simha means line. Line is a vyala. Shvapada. This dots. Kala, a very bad person. You can call him a dragon. Vyala. And sarpa, a serpent. And dushta gaja, a gaja which is uncontrollable. You know, they get this rut. When the rut juice comes out, madhajalam, becomes vyala. Shankara says, here he means the gaja. How? Duradarsha gajavate grihidu ashakyatva vyalaha. We cannot get hold of this Vishnu. So many asuras are trying to defeat him. They want to crush him. But you cannot. Just like an elephant, it's not possible. That elephant also Durgaja, the one with rut. Just like an elephant with Mada cannot be controlled, so also this Vishnu cannot be Grihitum Ashakya.
Do you have it in your menu?
What?
I don't see the Gaja thing here. In this
no,
one.
Even we don't.
Yeah.
No, we don't.
Oh, what
this one is Vyala Vagrahitu Mashakyatvat.
Vyala Vagrahitu Mashakyatvat. Okay. So, Duradarsha Gajavat is not there. Another patha is Bhujangavat. Bhujanga means serpent. So, let us just say Duradarshavat. Duradarsha means one who is difficult to control. We had it before. Duradarsha. That name had come before. Duradarsho. What is that? Duradarsho. Kritajna. Kritiratmavan. The last class. So Duradarsha means one who is unable to be, it's not easy to control. Gajavat is just a example, illustration. So Gajavat is not there, but you have got Duradarsha Vat Grihitum Ashakyatvat.
Not even Duradarsha.
Vyalavat Duradarsha.
Vyalavagra.
Vyalavat Duradarshatvat. Or Vyalavat
Grihitum Ashakyatvat.
Vyalavat Grihitum Ashakyatvat Vyalaha. One who is impossible to be got hold of like Vyala. Hence, he is also Vyala. He is also a Dushtagaja. Ahaha Samvatsaraha Vyalaha. The next one is Pratyayaha. What is Pratyaya? Pratitihi. What is Pratiti? Pratiti means appearance. How does things appear? Because of your prajna, because of your consciousness. So there is the meaning of pratyaya. Pratyaya means consciousness, prajna. Pratiti prajna pratyaya. That's what he says. And what is the authority? Aitareya Upanishad. Prajnanam brahma. This Brahman is verily prajnanam. Iti srutehe. Is that there?
Yeah, that is it. Prajnanam Brahmiti Sruti.
The next one is last one. Sarvadarshanaha. Ahasamvatsaro vyala pratyayaha. Sarvadarshanaha. Sarvadarshanaha. One who sees everything. Sarvani darshanatmagani akshini yasisaha. One who has got eyes which sees everything. Saha sarvadarshanaha. Sarvatmagatvat, because he is the inner soul of everyone. We don't see because we have eyes. We see because we have consciousness principle behind the eye. And he being the consciousness principle, he is the one who sees through all the eyes. Hence he is called sarvadarshanaha. That is Shankara's meaning. How do we know that? So he is quoting a Vedic sentence. Vishvata Chakshuhu. Is it there?
Mm-hmm.
The whole mantra is Vishvata Chakshurada Vishvato Mukho Vishvata Chakshurada Vishvata Spat Tambahubhyam Navati Sampatitro. This is the whole sentence. So just like Sahasra Shirasha Purushaha Sahasrakshaha. One who sees through countless thousands. Which means what? He is looking through all the eyes as consciousness principle. Then another Taittiriya Aranyaka. Vishwaksham. He is the eye of the world. Vishwaksham. It is Srudhe. Because of these two Srutis, he is Sarvadarshana. He is the one who sees through everyone. So that is over. Sarvadarshana. 23rd verse is over. Now the next one is Ajaha. What is it? Ajaha. Ja means what? To be born. Anuja means?
Older.
Yeah, after. And Ajaha means not born. Yeah. Ajaha is not born. Na jayate iti Ajaha. One who is not born. How? Rigveda Samhita. Na jato na janishyate. He was neither born nor will be born. So if you just say he is not born, then it is like your great grandson. Oh, maybe he is going to be born later. No, na janishyate. He is not going to be born, meaning he is always there. Na jataha na janishyate. It is srutehe. And also the Mahabharata. Nahi jato na jaye ham na janishye kadajana. So the Veda said future tense. Mahabharata says present, past and future. Nahi jataha, I was never born. Na jaye, I will not be born. Na janishye, I will not be born in the future. Kadajana, at any point. Kshetrajnya sarvabhuta nam tasmad aham ajasvrataha. That is why I am called Aja. Because I am the Kshetrajna, I am the witness consciousness in all creatures. Hence I am called Aja.
Kshetrajna,
how
does that translate to the witness consciousness?
Kshetram Janati, one who knows the field. Body. Kshetram is the body.
So one who knows the body.
Body means not this body, any body. Yeah, creation, not the physical body. Body means the phenomenal reality, the perceivable reality. That is Kshetram. Kshetram generally means what? Field. Field of consciousness. Tam janati, that field janati. Kshetram janati iti kshetrajnaha. Who is aware of the Kshetra? Who is aware of the field? The witness.
Is this other meaning that Kshetram is where putting Kshetram all the...
Yeah. Where also somebody is knowing that, no? Who is it knowing? Who knows it? Who is the knower?
What is that, sir?
Putting Kshetram is
Kshetram means a temple.
Temple or all the holy places.
Holy place. Kshetra-atan. No, atan means to move around. Kshetra-atanam. Kshetra-atanam means pilgrimage. Kshetradi is a pilgrim. The pilgrims who came to Boston. There are Kshetradins. The people who go after pilgrim centers. So Kshetradanam, that's the word they use in local language. Atati means to go around. So there also Kshetrajaha means one who knows the Kshetra is there, Punyakshetra.
Mm-hmm.
Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre. Mm-hmm. So Dharma Kshetra. Dharma Kshetra is the field of Dharma, because the battle has to be within the limits of legality. They cannot kill after the sun sets.
Mm-hmm.
Before the sun set, they have to stop the... After the sunrise, after everybody's breakfast and sandhyadhanam and everything, they have to start the... All these rules are there. That's why the war itself is fought in a Dharma Kshetra. So Kshetra means any field. So Kshetrajnaha Sarvabhutana. I am so in the body there are two birds. One is you, the Jiva, the other one is the Kshetrajna. Kshetrajnam Chabimam Vidhi Sarva Kshetre Shubharata says in the Gita, know me to be the Kshetrajna in all Kshetras. Kshetra Kshetrajnayor Jnanam Edat Jnanam Matam Mama. This is my firm opinion. If you know the difference between the Kshetra and the Kshetrajna, then you have known it all. Then you have got the Jnana. Once you know that, the difference, Kshetram and Kshetrajna. So he is Kshetrajna who is conceiving, who is witnessing the Kshetra. And that Kshetrajna is neither born, nor is being born, nor will be born. Hence he is called Ajaha. Iti Mahabharate. So Ajah Sarveshwaraha, right? Mm-hmm. Next one is Sarveshwaraha. Sarvesham Ishwaranam Ishwaraha. So he is the Ishwara of Ishwara. Why in the Brihadaranyaka, the Shruti says, Yesha Sarveshwaraha. He indeed, this Brahman indeed is Sarveshwara. Hence he is Sarveshwara. The next one is Siddhaha. Nitya Nishpanna Rupatvat Siddhaha. He is always available. Nitya Nishpanna means eternally available. So he is called Siddha. What is a Siddha Vastu? Something which you already got, like your head, it is Siddham. You don't have to go and attain it, like Ganesha. He doesn't have it, so he had to go and attain. But you already have it, so your head is Siddham. That is what, Nitya Nishpannam, it's always there with you. That is called Siddha. Since he is that, he is not like Ganesha, he is like always Purna. Hence he is Siddha. O Brahman. The next one is Siddhihi. Siddhihi means Samvid Rupatvat Sarva Vastushu. Samvid means consciousness or awareness. Samvid means awareness. One who is in the form of awareness in every object. Hence he is called Siddhi. Siddhi. Niradishaya Rupatva Dva. Niradishaya means something which is not great, nothing is greater than that. Adishaya means which is greater. So, comparatively, Niradishaya means nothing is greater than that. So, the Siddhi or success is Niratishaya. Why normally any result is, any result, any Siddhi or success you get, there is comparable. For example, if you get Surga, then there is some Sukha or happiness more than that. But this Brahman, it is Niratishaya. There is no greater attainment than the Brahman. Sorgadinam vinashitvat, because heaven etc. are temporary. They are culpable to destruction. Vinashi. Tasmad aphalatvam. Hence it is not Siddhi.
What is Sorgadinam again? Temple.
Sorga means heaven.
Heaven, right.
Sorga means Sorga. Mm-hmm. Adi means happiness, just like that.
Okay.
Sorga means what? Sukham. Sorga means it is a. Figure of, it's a image for happiness. When you say heaven, what is implied is happiness. Actually, this is the definition of Sarga by Mimamsaka, Sudhu Yagas for that. Enna dukkhena samvinnam, that which is not contaminated by unhappiness. So, normally when you build your own house, when you sit there, it is supposed to be like happiness. And when you're sitting, you get a call. Go and do the vacuum. There is a little bit dukkha there. In that sukha, there is a little bit dukkha. But in Swarga, no interruption. Uninterrupted happiness. There is the first line. Enna dukkhena sambhinnam nachagrastam anantaram. Later it doesn't go away. Once you got it, it's sure. It doesn't disappear. Tat padam swaspadas padam. That sukham is called Swarga. So even that Swarga, there is gradation in that happiness. And also it is Vinashi. Vinashi means it is destructible. How? Tetam bhutva punya lokam vishalam gita. Tetam punya lokam swargam bhutva. Swargam is not punya lokam. Punya lokam means you go there with a green card. What is that? Punyam. If you have the punyam, you are given entry. If you don't have the punyam, you cannot enter swargam. Tetam bhuktva swargalokam vishalam kshine punye martya lokam vishanti. When the punyam is kshina, the punyam is gone, he again comes back to martya loka, the temporary worlds. Hence, even the swarga is vinashi. But this siddhi, this brahman, is niratishayam. There is nothing greater than that. Hence, it is called siddhihi. So, first meaning was samvitrubam, consciousness or awareness. Second one was, there is no greater happiness other than this moksha, this Brahman. Hence, it is called siddhi. So, generally siddhi means success. So, any form of success means happiness, whatever you want it, you know. And once you get that, that is all further you can qualify it. There can be another success which is greater than that, another happiness greater than that. But this Atma Siddhi, Atma Lava, there is nothing comparable. Once you get it, that's it. There is nothing greater than that. Hence, it is called Nirathishaya Rupa Siddhi.
It's also used in the context of when people die, they have attained Siddhi, right?
Yeah. Any, like if you go to your goal, it's called Siddhi, okay. Target.
Target, okay.
They say, no, Buddhi Siddhi, two wives of married relation. So, Buddhi is intelligence, Siddhi is success. So, any success, but they are all pointers toward happiness. And this word that you said, that he attained Siddhi, is generally not used for papis.
Okay.
Used for sannyasis.
Useless, yeah.
Yeah. Because it's like His Holiness,
right.
He attained Siddhi. Meaning, that's not usually normally not spoken of for Abdul Qadir. It is used for great men. So, there is, you don't say they died. Because you know that they were Mahatmas.
Mm-hmm.
They had some spiritual attainment. So, Ramana Siddhi, Ramakrishna Siddhi, like that. And Siddhi means attaining what you already had. It's not something you go and get it like Swarga. And they don't come back from that state. So, Jivan Mukta, Siddhi. Siddha, Siddha Purusha. They also say that. Siddha means Siddhas or Jivan Muktas. Siddhi Sarvadi Rachyutaha. So, Sarvadihi, that is the next one. Sarvadihi. Adi Karanatvat Sarvadihi. He is the Adi Karana. So you have a Karana, and that Karana has another Karana. Chicken egg, chicken egg. Finally, it goes to Vishnu. Then he is Sarvadi, the beginning of all Karanas. For who is the Adi Karana? Sarvabhutanam. For all the created, the creation. Bhuta is Bhuyate, creation. That which is. So generally it is the five elements. Two you can see, three you can see, two you cannot see. I think it will come now. I'll go there. So Buddha is Panjabhutas. So Sarva Buddhas are all creation. Teshana Adhikaranam is the first cause. Ataha Sarva Adhihi. Sarva means all. Sarva means Sarva Buddhas. Adhihi means Adhikaranam. So from Sarva, the word Buddha came out, and from the word Adi, Karanam came out in Shankara. So that's how he calls it. Sarva Bhutanam Adi Karanatvat. He is called Sarvadihi. Sarvadihi. The next one is Achyutaha. Swarupa Samarthyat Nachyutaha Nachyavate Nachyavishyate. See, generally, this is called a tap pratyaya. Tap pratyaya means it is past participle. Like when you say gone, gone means gatam. What is gone? Gatam. And when you say eaten, eaten, say bhuktam. That's past participle. Or geetam, something which was sung. So normally this participle is always used in the past tense. It's always past tense. Similarly, chutam. Chutam means fallen. Chutam means fallen. So achyutam means infallible, not fallen. Then it implies past tense. That means it is limited by time. That Shankara doesn't want. He says Surupa Samrithyat, because of the capability of the Surupa of Vishnu, of Achyuta, of the word. Here it is just not part Chuta. It also means Nachyavate and Nachyavishyate. Normally it's only yeah, but here now you have to go extend it to future also. That's not something which is possible normally. But this is not a normal thing which you are talking about. Hence, he is Achyutaha. So, how can you say this? That this new meaning, how can you break the convention? So, that Shankara has to quote the authority. What is the authority? Shashvatagum Shivamachyutam. Shashvatagum Shivamachyutam. Taittiri Aranyaka. So, he is Shashvata, he is the eternal one. He is Shivam, he is the happy one. Shivam means happiness, auspicious. And Achyuta means infallible. So, this is a quotation to prove that he is infallible. Now, what about the future things? That meaning. Tathaja Bhagavadvajanam in Shanti Parva, in Mahabharata. Yasvan Achyuta Purvoham. I did not fall before Purvam. Before I did not fall, chuta purva aham na. Achyutas tena karmana. Hence I am called achyuta. Because of that act of not falling. Iti adhyam shatakam vivrutam. In this manner, 100 names have been commented upon. Iti thus adhyam first shatakam 100 verses
slightly different.
Vivrutam vivaranam
slightly different here.
Pratamam
na
pratamam adhi means pratamam shatam means shatakam. Okay. So that is over 100 names. What was the 100 name?
Achyuta.
So the Surupa Samrithya means, just like the fire, what is the Surupa Samrithya of the fire? Heat. By its nature, it has got heat. Similarly, the Brahman, by Surupa, it will not fall. It never fell. It's not falling. Hence, that is why he said that meaning. So Achyutam. Next one is Purushaka Pirameyatma, right? The next verse. Purushaka Pihi Ameyatma. Purushaka Pihi is one word. Like Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna means Rama and Krishna. Like that, Purushaka Pihi means Vursha and Kapihi. What is Vursha? Vursha usually means a bull. And usually, Dharma is envisaged as a bull. Why? Because the word Vursha also means Dharma. The word Vursha means Dharma. Sukrate Vrishabhe Vrishaha. The word Vrishaha means Sukritam or Punyam or Adishtam or Dharmam. And it also means a bull. Hence they keep saying that Dharma is like a bull. Just to, it's very easy for people who work for Amarchitra Kada. You can just draw it and show them. Because you cannot show otherwise, how is Dharma? Dharma is Adrishtam. Punyam you can never see. It is just like a fragrance. You cannot see, you can only feel it. Yatha punyasya karmano durad gandho vaha. Devam punyasya karmano durad gandho vati. That's what the Veda says. Just like yatha sampushpitasya vrikshasya durad gandho vati. Sampushpitasya vrikshasya. A tree which is full of flowers, it sends forth fragrance which you cannot see. You can see the flower, but you cannot see the fragrance. Similarly, the man's action, it creates some subtle reaction in people. That is called punyam. You can never see, but you can feel like the fragrance. That is punyam. And vrusha means that. Vrusha means sukritam. And vrusha also means a bull. Similarly, kapihi. Kapihi means a monkey. Kapi means what? But Shankara does not want monkey. So he says, anyway, vrusha means varshanat sarvakamanam vrusha. Why is this dharma called vrusha? What is the reason? Vrusha means varshati. That which pours, rains. Yeah, rains. Varshati, rains. Pours. It pours. Or it rains. So, varshanat, what is it is pouring? This vrusha or dharmam? Punyam, what is it pouring? Sarva kama naam, your desires. So you can have 1000 desires, but if you don't have 1000 punya, you are not going to get all of that. So it always depends upon your punya that you receive your kama. So who is doing this varsha of this kama? Punya. Punyo duswapranasanaha. Is going to come. That punya is also Vishnu. He already said that sarvam Vishnumayam. But punya means the dharma or the good you did, the good karma. He is called Vrsha here. Why he is called Vrsha? Because he is Varshati. The punya actually reigns. What does he reign? Sarva kama. Your desires. That is why he is called Vrsha. That is why dharma is called Vrsha. So only by dharma you will get your desires without the side effects, without the catchings. Otherwise there will be like fine print. If you just go and you can grab it, then there will be a lot of law will catch up with you. But if you do dharma, naturally it will come. You don't have to do anything. That is why it's called vrusha, because it's capable of pouring your kamas. You can easily fulfill everything. So, Varshanat Sarvakamanam Dharmaha Vrishaha. Hence, he is called a Vrisha. Kapihi now. Kapihi normally means what?
Monkey.
Here, Kapihi means, Ka means water. Kam Vayu Ramrudo, like that. Ka means water. Kath means from water. Ramat means from Rama. Kath means from water. That is what he is writing. Kath, Toyat. What is Toyam? Toyam means water. Toyam or Payas. Payam. Payaha. Paya. Ilala Amrutam. Amrutam means water. When you are very thirsty, you will understand that. Kilalam also means water. And Toyam also means water. That's what he is writing. Kath is equal to Toyat. From water. From water what? Bhumim Apath. Bhumi. Bhumi means earth. Apath means protected. Who protected the Bhumi, the earth, from sinking in the water? Kapihi. His name is Kapi. So, here Kapi means a pig, a boar. So, the Rudi meaning, what is the Rudi meaning? Conventional. Conventionally, Kapi means monkey. But here it is etymological meaning. It gives an etymology. That is called yoga. there are two kinds of words, right? Yogika and Buddha. If you say the conventional meaning, it's always monkey. But if you say the yogika meaning, a derivative, if you say the derivative meaning, no conventional meaning here, derivative meaning, it means varaha. That's what he's saying. Kapihi varaha. How come Kapi became varaha? Because Karpati, from water, protected who? Woman. Hence he is called varaha.
Varaha is
boar, yeah, pig. Boar is a well-sounding word. It's pig, yes, actually.
Third,
it sounds
third,
well, you know.
Third avatar.
Yeah. They say that, you know, people started eating fish. They started eating turtles, Chinese. And then they also started eating the boar. Hence, he became the fourth one, which is Narasimha, to scare them off, to protect himself. It's like a Ninda Stuti. I'll get the verse. There is a verse like that. Narasimha Stuti. So, Khat, Toyat, Jalat, Bhumim Apat. He protected the earth. Hence, he is called Kapihi Varahaha. So, he is actually, Vrsha Kapihi means then what? Dharma Varahaha. He is Dharma and Varahaha. He is a bull and a boar. Vrsha Rubatvat. Kapi Rubatvacha Vrsha Kapihi. So in the Vishnu Purana, he says that he took this Varaha Avatara to lift the Bhumi from the waters, from the primordial waters. He lifted it. So he's quoting some Shanti Parva, Mahabharata, O Shankara. What is that verse? Kapir Varaha Shrestascha. He is Kapihi, the Paramatma is Kapihi. Means what? Varahaha, the meaning. Sreshtascha Dharmaha. And he is also the most prominent Dharma. Vrsha Uchyate. Hence he is called Vrsha. Tasmat Vrsha Kapir Praha. Hence he is called Vrsha Kapi. Hence Vishnu is called Vrsha Kapi. Kashyapo Mam Prajapatihi. So Prajapati, the Desha Prajapati, 10 Prajapatis. First one is Kashyapa Prajapati. So the Kashyapa Prajapati started calling me Vrsha Kapi because I am the best among Dharma and I am also the one who lifted the earth. Iti Mahabharate. The next one is what? Vrsha Kapi Rameyatma. Ameyatma. Atma means self. Atma means self. Mayam. Mayam means measurable. Yeah. Manam means measurement. Manam means measurement. Mayam means that which is measured. If you can measure something, you can call it maya. But if you cannot measure, it is ameya. His self, you cannot measure. Yourself is very easy to measure. If I ask you, who are you? You will say, I am this. This means what? You are measurable. You are embodied. But Vishnu is Ameya. He is all over the universe. Hence, he is Ameya Atma. This is my commentary. Now, we will see Shankara. Iyaniti matum parichetum nasakyate. Iyan. Iyan means this much. Iyan means this much. Iyan iti. This much thus. Matum. Matum means parichetum. To limit. Measure means what? To limit. 2 by 2. You're limiting it. So you cannot limit it. Na shakyate atma. The self. Of whom? Asya. Iti ame atma. So that is the meaning of Amayatma. The funny thing about consciousness is you cannot measure it. So hence it is called Amayatma. I repeated myself. Okay. So Vrishakapi Rameyatma. First part of the verse is over. What is the next one? Sarva Yoga Vinisritaha. So, what is yogam? Nalla yogam adichide. They say that in Telugu, manchi yogam means he has attained some luck. So, usually yoga means a relationship. Yoga means what? A connection. Yoga just means connection. But he is out of all connections. Vinisridha means getting out. So, unattached. Sarva Yoga Vinisridha means one who got out of all connections. It is like this. We want to accomplish something, and for that you have to work for that accomplishment. Then you have to go and associate with the connected people or connected objects. Once you get that connection, then you attain it. And then you are not able to get off that. It's stuck. That is called yoga. And there is not one yoga. It's not just one attachment. So many things are like, what is Atapuchi in English? Leech. Yeah. Like leech, it's all stuck over your body. That is what yoga. Yoga is connection, you know. That is Sarva Yoga. So many connections, attachments. And you cannot just cut it asunder. You have to get out of that room. The room is full of bugs. You have to just move. That is what Vishnu is. Sarva Yoga Vinisritaha. How do you know that? How do you know that he is unattached? He says, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, Asango Hyayam Purushaha. This man is unattached. This man means this Atma. Pure Saiti. This is definitely not man. This is Purusha, that Paramatma. This Paramatma Ayam Asangaha. He got out of all attachments, all connections. It is Srutehe. Oh, now he is saying that Vinisritaha means not getting out. Vinisritaha means getting in. Going in. See, this going out, going in, it could, going in means, did it go in? Means what? Understand. Mm-hmm. There is a saying in Sanskrit. Gatyarthaganam jnanarthakatvam. Whatever, whenever you say gati, go, it also means no.
This thing also.
Yes, it comes, every time you say go, knowing also comes.
Right.
So he's taking that second time. First time he really said going. Going of attachments. Now he is saying knowing. How can you say knowing? Sarva Yoga. There are so many yogas. Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga. Through all this yoga, who is known? Vishnu. Sarva Yoga. Nana Shastrokta Yoga. Oh, so it is not Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga. Shastrokta Yoga. Nana Shastra. What are the Nana Shastra? Tarka Shastra, Sankhya Shastra. In all that Shastra, this knowledge, that which is understood, that is him. Nana Shastrokta Yoga Avagata. Avagata means understanding. That is yoga here. This seems to be a better one. It is not scary, leech at all. It's something you understand and it just goes away. That is what actually, that is what happens. It's not scary at all. Once you see it, it just slips off. It's like the snake slipping away from the rope. They could use better examples. So why do you say that he is understand from other Shastras? Aren't we talking about Shankara Bhasya and Vedanta? Then why is Shankara pulling the other Shastras? He says, Satsuja Vedanta Vakyeshu. tat artha darya artham vedanta vakya avirodhi bhavan anivaryate. If something is against Vedanta, he says, if something is against Vedanta, you can accept it. You can use modern science, whatever. As far as it does not oppose the central idea of Vedanta, that's why he said Sarva Shastra. Sarva Yoga Ministrita means what? One who is understood by Sarva Shastra. What is the use of Sarva Shastras? Why do we need all empirical science? Of course, if you can get the unity of Atma through that, well, be it. Shankara is open to that. That's why he says that. So that is,
Does that mean like all views like this step?
Sarva Shastra, everything, yeah. Any. Usually it's only six. It's only six darshanas. Not anything. Not Abdullah or all this. Just six. Shankhya, Yoga, Vaisheshika, Tarka, Puravimamsa, Uttaramimamsa. That is Sarva Shastra for him. Definitely not all. Because if you can, then it will become like unlimited. And Shankara is somebody who wants to be very clear on things. He won't say it like, he has to clearly state it. So what was the last one? Sarva Yoga Vinishtha. Sarva Yoga Vinishtha means the second meaning was Sarva Shastreshu Avagataha. One who is known by the help of all Shastras. Now, this Sarva Yoga Vinishtha, here you saw the word Avagata. Okay. What is the exact word? Nana Shastrartha Yogat Avagata Dva. Apagata. Oh, that is why. See, I have Avagata. In some places it is Apagata. Mm-hmm. Apagata means one who is not understood. One who is not understood means what? One who is understood only by Vedanta. You cannot understand him by any art, music, nyaya, vyakarana, nothing. He is understood only here. If you think that Shankara wrote like that, pa instead of va, then that is the meaning. That is the second meaning. Got it? I said avagadadva, but then you saw it apagadadva. Avagadadva means if he is not opposed to Vedanta, we will accept. Apagadat means no. Not understood by anything other than Vedanta. So in case of that patha, that reading, variant reading, you take that meaning. One who is not understood by any other source other than Vedanta. Sarva Shastra Anavagata, one who is not apagata, means not understood. So Sarva Yoga Vinishtaha. Next one is Vasu. Vasu means they are a Ganadevata. Vasanti Sarvabhudani Atraidi Vasu. That is the first meaning. So in all the Bhutas, they are staying where? Where are all the creatures staying? They are staying in a locus. Finally it becomes the consciousness. For example, this Bhutam staying in the carpet. That is on Solan. And that is in the earth. Finally, you get to consciousness. That is why he is called Vasu. Vasanti Sarva Bhutani Atra. All the Bhutas stay in space. And space stays in consciousness. Hence, he is called Vasu. That is the number one meaning. Number two meaning, Teshu Ayam Api Vasati Dva. Otherwise, this guy, this Vasu, this consciousness is going and sitting in everything. So one is like, he is, everything is sitting on him. Second one is, he is sitting on everything. Andar Behishya Tat Sarvam Vyapya Narayana. Up above everywhere his consciousness is. So that is the second meaning. Teshu Ayamapi Vasati Tiva Vasuhu. Third meaning, Vasunam Pavakas Chasmi. Among the Vasus, I am Agni. He says in the Gita. Ityuktova. That is the third meaning. So, who are the eight Vasus? Like the nine Grahas, the 7 days of the week, and Rahu and Ketu. Like that, there are eight Vasus. Sapta Rishi. Seven Rishis. Ashta Vasu. The eight Vasus. Who are they? Dhruva, Dharma, Soma, Varuna, Vayu, and Agni. Then Pratyusha, Prabhasa. These are the eight Vasus. So Agni is also included in that eight Vasus. And in that Ashtavasu, I am Agni. Vasunam Pavakas Chasmi. I am Pavaka. I am Agni. That's what who says, Krishna says.
What are these Vasus? What are the eight? Like what qualifies them into
Vakur? They are a Ganadevata, like Navagraha. Okay, the Navagrahas are the planets, so that is what connects them. That they have in common. The Ekadasha Rudras, they are all Shiva's form. That is in common. The Dvadasha Adityas, the 12 suns, one for each month, January sun, February sun. That Aruna. 130, it has the list of 12 sons. Arugu, Raja, Padarapatangaha, Swarnaru, Marichi. All these are 12 names of sons. Every month he gets a new, you get a new son actually. So that is what is common for the Dwadasha Adityas, Ekadasha Rudras, Dasha Prajapatis. They are all mind born of Brahma, Navagrahas, Saptarishis. They are all Maharshis. Panchakanya, they are all, though married, they are all virgin. Chaturvedas, Trigunas, they are all from Prakriti. Shiva and Shakti, for Brahman. So there is some common, these Ganas are common. What is common for the Vasu? Yeah, I'm going to tell.
Six. What is the six?
The six faces of Kartikeya.
Kartikeya.
He came from the six women, no? What is that? Six women?
Kati.
That, you know the names? They are the six virgins. They took that in the Kumara Sambhavam, Kalidasa. It was flowing through the Ganges and they took it.
I don't know the names.
You know the song Saravana Pradil? Or you can say the Shat Ritus.
Okay.
The six seasons.
Okay.
Hemanta, Varsha, all that. They are six. They are grouped because they are all seasons. So what is it, this eight Vasus? They say, they all stay in the Aditya Mandala. The Agni, Vayu, Dhruva, they all stay in the Aditya Mandala. So they are, that's why they are grouped together. It is just an explanation. But that's what they say. You find it in the Amarakosha. Amarakosha is tough. Amara means the name of the author. He is Amaras Maharishi Jain. And he also starts it with Deva Gana. He first talks about Gana Devatas. All the 11 names of Rudras, the 8 names of Vasus, he puts it there. So they are grouped like a Gana. Just like in Solon, they have this North group, South group. People group it for various purposes. So these Vasus are grouped because they all are together in the Aditya Mandala. Accepted? Yes. Vasunam Pavakas Chasmi. Among all the Vasus, I am Pavaka, I am Agni. So I think he is the most brilliant of the eight Vasus. He is the ringleader. Vasuhu. So these are the three meanings. And then Vasushabdena Dhanavachina Prashastyam Lakshate. Usually Vasu means money. Vasumati. Pasu means rich person. So because because money is so respected in this world, by calling him Vasu, he is also well respected. That is suggested. So Vasu, next one is Vasu Mana. The next word is? So Vasu is over. He just, the last one was just a commentary. He said that the word Vasu is used because just like wealth is famous in this world, the word Vasu is to denote that Vishnu is very famous. Just like wealth is well known, Vishnu is also well known. To say that the Vasu was used. Also he quoted the Gita to say that he is Pavaka, one of the Vasus. Now the next one is Vasumana. So what is Vasu here? Precious Dham. Vasu means what? Famous. Like the wealth. Vasumana means famous mind. Vasumana means what? Famous mind. Yasya Saha. What is a famous mind and normal mind? What is a beautiful mind and a mind? Beautiful mind is some Nobel Prize winning person has. You don't have it. So that is why it's called a beautiful mind. Like that, Vasumana means a famous mind means what? What is the beauty of that mind? He says, Ragadveshadihi kalushidam chittam tat prashastam. The famousness or the greatness of this mind is, it doesn't have ragadvesha. It has no attachments. That's why he is Vasumana. Ragadveshadihi. Why ragadvesha? Kleshahi. It is really klesha. Klesha means difficulty. When your mind has dvesha, it's not easy. It's a tough mind. Because it's like carrying fire in your, literally in your heart. You'll sweat because of dvesha. That is why it's klesha. Klesha means sweat, difficulty. And his mind is not like that. So that is the prashastyam. That is the fame part. That is the greatness. Ragadveshadibhi kleshaihi. Difficulties such as raga, dvesha, etc. Madadibhi upakleshaihi. Then there are assistant kleshas. Lesser kleshas. What is that? Mada. Moha. Itaha na kalushitam. Since it is not contaminated. Kalusha means? Kalusha means contaminated. Since his mind is not contaminated by all this. Prashastam manaha. Vasu manaha. His mind is famous. So generally Vasu means wealth. Why? Because famous. It is famous in that sense. But here Vasu Mana, one who has wealthy mind. What is a wealthy mind? A mind which does not have raga, dvesha and moha, mada. Klesha and upaklesha. Okay. That's it. That is Vasu Mana.
What is meant by the mind?
It means he has to protect you. Before that, he has to think. How does he protect you without thinking? Do you think he can protect you without thinking? When the Gajendra calls, oh Vishnu, come and protect me. And he will actually ask Lakshmi, should I go? And she says, okay. Then that's how they say it. What is Vishnu's mind? Vishnu has got a mind. It's called Samashti. And our minds are like small. It is limited to this. Our mind is Kinchitnyaha. It understands a little bit. And Vishnu's mind is Sarvajnaha. How will he know without a mind? He has to have a mind. Vishnu means, I am talking about the four hands, that Vishnu. Not the Brahman. The Nirgunam does not have mind. Amanaha, Achakshuhu, Apranaha. It says that, no, it doesn't have an eye. It's the eye of the eye, but it doesn't have an eye. It doesn't have a mind. That is the big one. But Vishnu has wife. He has a mind. He has thoughts. But he does not have Ragadvesha. He has a prashastam manaha. it is not a mind that is known. It's very unlike any other mind. Because he is Ishvara. So, Akulushitam Chittam, that is the mind of the Devata. Devata's mind is, the Vishnu's mind is Akalushitam, uncontaminated. How are you going to be devotee of Krishna if you think that his mind is contaminated? He is like, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam, we say that. He is Bhagavan, means what? He is Brahman Saguna form. If Brahman comes in a form, it will look like Krishna. And his mind is pure. It does not have Ragitvesha. I take it for granted that Vishnu's mind is uncontaminated. But did I explain that it is Prashastam? But then you can ask, it's a beautiful question actually. When you say that, how can this God have mind? Then what is the difference between me and him? The answer is, my Krishna has mind, but when he is Parabrahma, he does not. So this is two roles he plays at will. You don't play it at will. Krishna says that. With Bhuni me vetitani janmani tavacharjuna tanyaham veda sarvani. My mind knows everything. Natvam vetha parantapa. But your mind does not know. Says that. So, one who deliberately comes to this world to protect and to Sambhavami Yuge Yuge, to Dharma Paripalanartham, he is Ishvara. And his mind is free of Ragadvesha. That is why he is called Vasumana. He is called Vasumana because his mind is Prashastam. It's a beautiful mind. It is not like our mind. And this doubt is very good, accepted, because you are asking from your perspective. You are Saguna and he is Nirguna. So in the Nirguna status, there is no mind. In the Saguna status, there is mind, but it is different from our mind. It is a Prashastam Manaha. Now tell me.
I was asking, there is the same like what? Where is Hiranyagarbha then?
No, you are not. Sorry. See, if you are a Bhagavata, if you are ISKCON Hare Krishna Hare Rama, yes, then you say Krishna. Yes. If you are a yogi, see, there are several paramparas. Rudra Sampradaya, Brahma Sampradaya. Like that, there is a Hiranyagarbha Sampradaya. That is new for you now. No, really. That is why they call them Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha samavartatagre dhata. So he is called Dhata and he is Hiranyagarbha. So they don't worship all this. They hate ISKCON, all this. They don't go to Sri Vidya or any. None. All they do is sit and meditate. And they have got it. Like Nareshwar, they have this Adinath Sampradaya. Like that, they have Hiranyagarbha Sampradaya. They belong to that. One Sampradaya does not cancel out another one. It actually complements it. Why? In the beginning we said that. Upasya Bhedat. Because the Upasaka is different. Brahmano Rupakalpana. This Brahman becomes Hiranyagarbha, Vishnu, etc. But I really like that question. How can Vishnu have a mind? I'm going to answer that it is Vasumana. I understand it has to come to your mind. Like how can you even think that he can have Ragadvesha? That is what it is. Yeah, because he has a mind. And he has a mind which is not contaminated. So Shankara writes very clearly, Na kalushitam chittam tan manaha prashastam. That mind is famous where there is no kalushya, where there is no contamination. And what is that contamination? Klesha and Upaklesha. Difficulties less and greater. Klesha is greater difficulty, Upaklesha is lesser difficulties. The greater difficulty is Dvesha, the lesser difficulty is Mada, arrogance, pride. And then hatred. So Vasamana over. Vasar Vasamana. I will not forget this name. Next one is Satyaha. Next one is what? Satya. Vasar Vasamana Satyaha. Do it next class. Susti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahisha Subramane Bhya Shubhamasya.